Hello everyone, I am Vishwajit Joshi. Welcome to my channel Vishi Explores. Today we will be discussing about data center and data racks. So let's get started. Prior to it, we will have a brief look about what a data rack looks. This is the network side of the data rack and this is the data handling side of data rack. So now we just saw how a data rack looks. Now we will be speaking more about it. Yes, what is a data rack? A data rack is a place where all the data is stored, and data center is a place where each and every data rack is placed. Data center is a place where we have a large amount of very tight security. There are various layers of security protocols to be followed over there. Data center is nothing but a place where large amount of data is stored in forms of data racks. Data center is a place where we find very much important and very highly integrated security systems in place. Data center is a place where each and every company keeps its own data and it is provided to other users. Recently we heard about Facebook or other social media sites saying that they provided their data to some other companies by some their fault. So what was it? Basically, when a company or an individual says that he or she has leaked his data, this means the person has provided an access to data center and data rack to a third party, which is unauthorized. To gain an access to a data center and data rack, you need to have prior permission. So let's begin. What is data center? Data center is a place where we find large amount of data racks being stored with high memory and hard drives being placed over there. Data center is a place which consumes a lot and lots of amount of electricity. This place cannot have power failures. If there is power failure, the data center will collapse, which is unwanted. So, a data center has an uninterrupted power supply through all course of time. It has its own backup system, generator backup system, or some power grid. A data center consists of data racks. Now, what is data rack? A data rack is something which consists of RAMs, hard drives, some computer interface, air conditioning system, fire suppression system, some switches, some patch panels, etc. Let's get started to a data rack. Well, let's begin with data rack. So first, in data rack we have UPS. What is a UPS? A UPS is an uninterrupted power supply. This is used in case there is an emergency power failure. What this does? A UPS provides some external electricity to the data rack in case there is some power failure. After UPS, we see router. Well, what is a router? Router is something which reroutes all the data packages coming to it. This uses the routing protocol or routing policy to transfer data from one source to another source. When a data packet comes in one of the lines, the router reads the network address information in the packet to determine the ultimate destination of the packet. Then, using information in its routing table or routing policy, it directs the packet to the next network of its journey. After router, we have firewall. Well, what is a firewall? This word we might have come across while searching or while using internet. Well, let us understand what is a firewall. In computing, a firewall is a network security system that monitors and controls incoming and outgoing network traffic based on predetermined security rules. A firewall typically establishes a barrier between the trusted internal network and untrusted external network, such as internet. Firewalls are often categorized as either network firewalls or host-based firewalls. Network firewalls filter traffic between two or more networks and run on the network hardware, whereas host-based firewalls run on the host computers and control network traffic in and out of those machines. After firewall, we see a switch. A switch in the context of networking is a high-speed device that receives incoming data packets and redirects them to their destination on the local area network, also called as LAN. A LAN switch operates at the data link layer, that is layer 2, or the network layer of the OSI model, and as such it can support all types of packet protocols. Essentially, switches are the traffic cops of the local area network. This was the textbook definition of the switch. Now, let us understand the switch in a networking language. A switch is an Ethernet-based LAN which reads incoming TCP/IP data packet or frames containing destination information as they pass into one or more input ports. The destination information in the packet is used to determine which output will be used to send the data on its intended destination. Switches are similar to hubs, but way smarter than hubs. A hub simply connects all the nodes on the network. Communication is an essential haphazard manner with any device trying to communicate at any time, resulting in many collisions. A switch, on the other hand, creates a magnetic or an electronic tunnel between source and destination ports for a split second that no other traffic can enter. This results in communication without collisions. Switches are similar to routers as well, but a router has an additional ability to forward packets between different networks, whereas a switch is limited to node-to-node communication on the same network. After switch, we have a CCTV setup. Well, we all know what CCTV setup is. CCTV is used for the security purpose of the data center and data rack. When I say security purpose, it means the CCTV setup captures all the images of the person entering the data center and person who wants to use data rack. When I say who wants to use data rack, I mean an engineer who is eligible and authorized person to handle the data rack only. After CCTV setup, we have patch panel. Well, prior to patch panel, there's one more thing to add in CCTV setup. Here, the data rack which we saw today comprised of a CCTV setup for 4 cameras and 4 channel only. Now, let's get started to patch panel. A patch panel is something which I will be defining as follows from a textbook definition which I saw on the internet. A board in a switchboard, computer or other device with a number of electric sockets that may be connected in various combinations is known as a patch panel. Different systems have a functional unit that increases efficiency and the usefulness of such systems. In the case of cabling, patch panels represent the functional unit, and without them, the transmission of the data is rendered ineffectively. Ideally, a patch panel consolidates all the horizontal cabling in any piece of infrastructure. They allow one to terminate long and troublesome cables so that the signal is connected directly through a patch cord to its destination. Basically, what it does is reduces the length of the cables being used in a data rack and provides one direct access to the network so that two networks can be connected or two devices can be connected through patch panel. A patch panel is the major link which collects data and routes it to the intended destination. If a malfunction of a patch panel occurs, the entire system may fail, which explains how crucial the patch panel is. Patch panels are always found in the telecommunication section of a building, enabling the ease of managing telecommunication networks. So guys, always keep your patch panels safe. After patch panel, we have rodent repellent system. Well, a rodent repellent system is very much essential in data rack and in data center as well. Rodents and various small species are the ones which can roam around freely in any conditions. Here, this data center and data rack provides them a very much cool place to live. So, we don't need a rodent to come into our data rack and chew all the cables. So, we have a rodent repellent system. Well, what is the rodent repellent system's job and what it does? A rodent repellent system is an intelligent system which helps in keeping rodents away from the protected area with high frequency ultrasonic sounds. The powerful sound waves generated by the transducers and of repellers are within the hearing range of many pests and cause them pain and discomfort. Sometimes they will leave the area in say around 1 week, or it may take them few days as well. The powerful sound waves which are generated by the rodent repellent system are not harmful to the human beings, but they cause some pain to the rodents and pests. All the devices which we just saw and heard about them produce a large amount of heat when they are run on 24 hours basis on daily. So, in order to keep these devices cool and prevent heat, we need to have some air conditioning system. Although the data center provides itself an external cooling system in form of air conditioning system and central cooling system, this is not that much sufficient for a data rack to cool itself. So, Immersion Smart Rack comes with an integrated inbuilt air conditioning system. Well, this air conditioning system is kept at the bottom of the rack. Here, the air conditioning system monitors all the heat generated by the devices and automatically considers the amount of cooling required. Well, after the air conditioning system, this marks the end of our networking side of a data rack. On the other hand, that is the other side of the rack, we see all the data handling and storing procedural devices. Well, let us have a look at what these devices do. The data handling side starts with the dummy panels. Well, these dummy panels are kept here for future expansion or future use of the data rack. Below the dummy panels, we have tape storage. Yes, the tape storage is used for scheduled backup, which is taken as per the schedule. The schedule may be based on hourly basis or daily basis or weekly basis. The schedule may be programmed by the network engineer. The tape is useful for taking a full backup and an incremental backup as well. Below the tape, we have rack servers. Let us know more about rack servers. In this data rack, we have totally 3 rack servers. Between those 3 rack servers, we have an Evisent panel. The rack servers. A rack server is also called as a rack mounted server. It is a computer dedicated to use as a server and designed to be installed in a framework called as a rack. The rack contains multiple mounting slots called bays, each designed to hold a hardware unit secured in place with screws. Between the rack servers, as I told you earlier, we have an Evisent panel. Let us know more about this Evisent panel. The Evisent panel is a console for the servers and various devices which are placed in here. Below the Evisent panel, we have server chassis. A server chassis is a metal structure that is used to house or physically assemble servers in various different form factors. Server chassis makes it possible to put multiple servers and other storage and peripheral equipment in a single physical body. Then, this is similar to chassis of a vehicle. There, all the elements are being assembled on one single chassis. A server chassis is primarily designed to reduce the amount of physical space consumed by a standard server. Generally, a server chassis is used in environments where multiple parallel servers are needed to work. This is seen on a core business application. They typically are not designed to be connected to a display device, but can be connected to display device as well. That is a laptop, monitor, Sarrochesis comes in various forms, including rack and pedestal, that is tower. They can be classified according to their physical dimensions and are termed as being a 1U, 2U, up to 20U's. And moreover, where U represents the number of units. Typically, a 1U server can house up to 2 servers in a rack or tower. A server chassis can easily be upgraded, that is, or extended to add more servers, such as upgrading from 1U to 2U. As I told you earlier, the dummy panels are set for this only, for extension. After the chassis, now it's time for the hard disk. Well, hard disk is the space or a place where all the information is stored in data center and in data rack as well. But what is actually a hard disk? A hard disk is an electromechanical data storage device that uses magnetic storage to store and retrieve digital information using one or more rigid, rapidly rotating disks or platters coated with magnetic material. The platters are paired with magnetic heads usually arranged on a moving actuator arm, which reads and writes data to the platter surface. Data is accessed in the random access memory or random access manner, meaning that in individual blocks of data, can be stored and or retrieved in any order and not only in sequential. Hard drives are a type of non-volatile storage, retaining stored data even when powered off. Well, hard drives, we all know hard drives. Everyone have hard drives in their mobile phones, cameras, laptops and what. We have evolved from 512 KB to 1 TB or more. The hard drive is being used in the data rack today we saw, comprised of 24 channels, that is, the hard drive had 24 ports, out of which 10 ports were in use. The hard drive placed over there were of a minimum of 1 TB. So, a 1 TB hard drive multiplied by 10 ports provides 10 TB storage, and which can be extended up to 24 ports as well. But there's one more thing to know, that the requirement of the data center or data rack is not of 1 TB only. You can put a hard drive of much more capacity or more or less capacity as well. Below the hard drive again, we see an air conditioning system. Yes, this air conditioning system is same as the one we saw earlier in the network side as well. Also, in the data rack, we had some security protocols to be followed. The first one was of a finger scanner and an iris scanner. After entering the data center and data rack, there were some special sensors as well. The data rack comprises of integrated fire suppression or fire extinguisher sensors. As the sensor senses a fire, it will send an alarm to the verified mobile and verified email address. Also, it will automatically activate all the fire safety protocols. The second one is a humidity sensor. This sensor measures the humidity inside the data rack, as the doors are always closed so that there is no tampering. The humidity sensor is directly connected to the air conditioning system. Depending upon the humidity, the air conditioning system also works and accordingly sets the temperature. Also, there is one sensor for safety which sends an SMS and an email to a verified person once the doors of the data rack are open. Friends, now let us see what actually a data rack looks. So, this is how actually a data rack looks, and we are going to go inside and watch it closely. But prior to that, let's see how its security is. First, we have your fingerprint scanner, also an iris scanner, which I have already unlocked and opened it for you. Come on, let's get inside. This is the network side of the data rack, and this is the data handling side of data rack. Here in the network handling side, we see two UPS being placed although you would not be able to see it clearly because of the glass over here, but this is highly recommended not to open by amateur like me. We need to have access to open this. Although you may be seeing here a key, but this won't open at all. I'll show you it another time. So let's focus over here. These are the UPS. The upper two parts are the UPS. Below UPS, we see a Cisco 1900 series router. Below router, we have Liebert RDU-AG2 performance monitoring switch. After router, we see a firewall. This is a FortiGate 60D firewall. Below firewall, we have switch. This black panel with blue cables is switch. Below switch, we see a CCTV surveillance system. This is a surveillance monitoring system used over here. Below it, we see dummy places. This can be used as future experiment or future expansion. Below this, again there is some cable which is connected somewhere else in this system. Below it, here, this RSCAT, this is the rodent repellent system. This is used for rodent repulsion and so that rodents keep away and don't come inside the data rack. Below the rodent repellent system, we have integrated AC for this data rack. This data rack comprises itself air conditioning, air cooling system, which unfortunately I cannot show you. This is completely underground. This marks the end of our networking side. This is the networking side and this is that all the data handling side. So guys, let's get started the data handling side of the data rack. This part is the dummy part which can be used as future expansion. This, and this. Until here, it is. Until here, the red LED light, it is all dummy. This portion which you can see is the tape. Below tape, we have one rack server. Below this rack server, I don't know whether you can see it, but here I'll try and focus and put some torch over here. This, as you can see, is Avocent panel below one server, one data rack, sorry. Below it, you have another two data racks. Those green lights are coming out from data rack. Below it, again, you see here a 14 server chassis, 14 channel server chassis, out of which currently 1, 2, 3, 5 are in use. You can see a 5. Yeah. Here below the rack server, rack chassis, we have a hard disk. This is 24 port hard disk space available here, out of which we can see 10 slots are being used. Below this is the air conditioning system of data rack. So if we close all the lightings and look at data rack, this is how actually it looks.